Look, this is Boston. It was flown a couple of weeks ago with one of our partners. This is just an aerial photography, but processed into a 3D digital twin. Some of you are familiar with Boston, but this 3D base map picture is here shown integrated in with the vector data of Boston, like bus routes, or isn't it beautiful, actually? I mean, it's so stunning. Okay. I'm zooming in and I'm seeing a 3D building, a BIM model, resting inside of this 3D picture. That's extraordinary. It means that I can mix vector and raster and building information all into one information set. And I can integrate it in with the rest of my GIS. This is the skyline of Boston. The red areas are showing the most recent buildings that are built. And you can see Boston Commons, those of you who know it. It's kind of the central park of Boston. And so the vector attributes of these buildings are shown behind this 3D picture. And I can go underground. I can look here at water lines, actually. So I want to get across this notion that we're moving to 3D GIS, and we'll be maintaining it with BIM updates and feature updates, and it'll bring in all of the various information. This is a 3D condominium with 3D zoning. I can zoom right into this particular building and look at rooms and so on. Isn't it cool? And by the way, here's crime. Real-time crime in Boston. It's not really real-time, but it could be. So that you see overlays of information. I can also do land use planning, like using ArcGIS on Urban to mock up what the 3D zoning envelopes are. And looking at these 3D zoning I'm looking into the future, being able to communicate effectively in a game engine environment with citizens. Look at realistic renderings of these very same buildings. This is not fantasy land. This is actually technology that exists.